traffic, we have, say, a light westerly, and it's obvious everybody is using 8. I want to work in with the traffic and use 8 as well.
Okay.
Even though it's a little bit of a downwind landing. Bit of wheel brake while you slide it up all the way back so that it doesn't drag you over the top of the rope. Lock down your brakes.
up a little bit, move down, watch for the slack, stop release, pull it. So you gotta pull it right. Here's where you want to move up, move down, watch for the slack, now pull. Okay, if you go up to the right, he goes down and to the left. Now along the ridge, you go straight because he's gonna go to the right. Any other time when you're on tow and you get off tow, you go right, tow plane goes left. Okay? All right. Okay, let's clear left. We'll go out into the box a little deeper. Alright. I got him right there. Put the nose on the point. Okay, follow me through. We're going to review steep turns. Good. So, if I know that I'm going to be asked to do a steep turn, I want a little more speed because if it's truly steep, you want to make sure you're a good margin above both. Okay, clearing to the left. Here we go. It takes a lot of rudder to get that nose to travel in a steep turn. A fair amount of back stick to keep the nose up. Any time that it gets a little bit away, getting too fast to your seat, roll out a little bit. I mean, you're going to have to anticipate your rollout on the point. And then maybe do the same thing, turn and then make your seat turn. And then when you come around, roll out, clear again, and roll right into your seat turn the other way. Down on it.
this glide right now.
Actually, you know what? You got a little headwind. Let's go past. I estimated a 10 up here. So instead of 55, we're going to be 60.
Good.
We cover ground. We're going into the wind. I got skydivers coming down on the left.
Yeah.
Okay. fact that landing downwind, we're going to tend to roll kind of a long ways.
Right.
We may end up rolling past them. We're not going to want to try to do a panic stop. So we'll probably roll past them. And, still better than opposing them. I've got it for a minute. I'm going to try to hang out. It's better than trying to oppose their takeoff direction.
Okay.
He's clearing for traffic right now. There's one reason you want to not only be looking in the air, but be looking at activity on the ground. What I'm really hoping is that he will start his launch pretty soon, and we'll be able to actually make another pattern.
Okay.
Normally, we can always adjust our pattern if they're a little bit slow of getting out there, but if they're, like, if they're not moving at all, you got to go ahead and land.
Alright.
It looks like they're getting ready to go. Okay. Once he's rolling, we're going to start our approach. Good, very good. And you know, you landed a little bit tail first, doesn't matter. Landing downwind, you almost need to do that if you're going to try to stop in a normal amount of distance.
Okay.
If you make a hot approach and you got a little bit of tailwind, you're going to have a long rollout.
Yeah, and it's like ground speed was a little
forward a bit. That was good, all went good.
Okay, and yeah, without that 20 knot headwind, your ground speed's a little bit higher coming in. You just look kind of hotter than normal, but
yeah. You're good for so